Around 3 months ago, I got this comment. I would like to suggest that you make a video talking about the main areas in which we can apply for a master's degree. Without a shadow of a doubt, all areas involving the environment are important, but we're going through several changes and environmental problems are only getting worse. Do we have solutions to these problems? Yes, we have. But do we have people prepared to provide these actions? Specialized people? That's where my suggestion comes from. Thank you so much for this comment. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the areas in environmental sciences that you can specialize when doing a master's degree. Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're new, my name is Katlego, and if you're a returning subscriber, welcome back to another video. As you've seen, today's video we're talking about specializations in environmental sciences. So without wasting any time, let's get into it. As we all know by now, because I've talked about it so many times, environmental sciences is a multidisciplinary field, and there are several main areas where you can apply for a master's degree in this field. These areas cover various environmental aspects, such as environmental science, management, and policy, and there are some common main areas. So, number one, the area you can specialize in, environmental management. It focuses on sustainable resource use, pollution prevention, and environmental planning. It includes courses on environmental policy, risk assessment, and environmental impact assessment. I'm actually very much interested in environmental impact assessment, but because I didn't do management and I did science, it's something I have to do outside of my degree. But if you are looking to know more about environmental management, you can check out links in description because I've made videos talking about it before. The second area of specialization is ecology and conservation, my favorite. So if you did not know, I have a master's degree in environmental sciences specializing in biodiversity conservation. I think that's what my specialty is, actually. So ecology and conservation concentrates on the study of ecosystems, biodiversity, and conservation strategies. It involves fieldwork, data analysis, and conservation planning. So I have videos where I talk about my master's degree to an extent, and I also have videos where I recorded myself doing fieldwork. So because I did environmental sciences in this particular specialization, I did a lot of fieldwork, I did a lot of data analysis, I did a lot of writing in terms of the scientific method. And I will be having a video probably next week talking about environmental conservation if you're interested. So keep an eye out for that one. Number three, climate change and atmospheric sciences. So climate change and atmospheric sciences, this specialization explores climate science, climate change impacts, and adaptation strategies. It includes studies on atmospheric science, meteorology, and climate modeling. It's a very, very fascinating field to me because, again, I'm just interested in a lot of environmental aspects, and it's stuff I'm learning outside of my degree because I did not specialize in that. But if you're interested, I can have a video, maybe get somebody who did specialize in this field to come and talk about it. Number four, environmental policy and planning. It examines the development and implementation of environmental policies, focuses on regulatory frameworks, policy analysis, and sustainable development planning. Again, a lot of people who work in this specific field or who have specialized in this work mostly in consultancy and in private sectors, but I still think it's a very interesting field to specialize in. Obviously, as I am going through this list of specializations, whichever catches your fancy, you can do some more research about it. Number five, water resource management. This specialization concentrates on the sustainable use and management of water resources. It involves studying hydrology, water quality, and water policy. A lot of people who end up doing a BSc in environmental management do touch a little bit on water resource management. Number six, environmental health sciences. I remember sometime last year, I had somebody ask me if there's a difference between environmental sciences and environmental health sciences. I'll probably make a video on that as well, because I actually don't know what the difference is. Again, I know what I did, but I think it would be interesting to learn a little bit more about it. So this specific specialization explores the impact of environmental factors on human health. So whereas science focuses on the science behind environmental situational aspects, we try to understand the science behind the environment. What causes this? What's happening here? How can we, you know? Environmental health sciences focuses more on the relationship between humans and the environment and how these two things affect each other. So this specialization includes studies on environmental toxicology, epidemiology, and risk assessment. Number 7, renewable energy and sustainable technology focuses on sustainable energy sources, technology, and energy policy. It involves studying renewable energy systems, energy efficiency, and green technology. Again, another area that is quite big considering the sustainable development goals. Number 8, environmental education and communication. I think this is another field I'm trying to tap into. Again, I'm just interested in a lot of stuff, and I'm somebody who enjoys learning. So environmental education and communication is something I'm quite passionate about considering this YouTube channel. So this specific field concentrates on raising awareness and promoting environmental stewardship. It involves developing educational programs and communication strategies. Again, how do you teach people about environmental sciences? How do you advocate, well, not environmental sciences, but environmental field as a whole? How do you push forward certain initiatives to make sure that people care about them? Number 9, wildlife biology and conservation. Again, this is similar to ecology and conservation, but this more focuses on the wildlife aspects in a country or in the world. This specialization focuses on the study and conservation of wildlife populations, as I've mentioned. It involves fieldwork, biodiversity monitoring, and habitat conservation. So in my internship, I touched a little bit more on this particular aspect of the environment, or this particular specialization. And number 10, the last one, is environmental data science. Environmental data science. I love it because I think GIS falls into it, and I'm like, I'm just crazy about GIS. But environmental data science integrates data science techniques and environmental science applications. It involves data analysis, modeling, and the use of technology for environmental monitoring. So for example, you collect data in the wild, you model, you create maps, all of these things that are able to help scientists or policymakers make decisions regarding the environment or wildlife or whatever. So that is what environmental data science involves. So when choosing a master's program, consider your specific interests within the broad field of environmental sciences, as well as the strengths and focus areas of the university and institutions offering that specific program. Additionally, gaining practical experience through internships or research projects can enhance your learning and prepare you for a career in your chosen environmental science field. For example, when I chose a specialization in biodiversity conservation, is because of all my majors that I've done in undergrad and in my honors degree, that was the one aspect of environmental sciences that drew me the most. That is the one that I was interested in the most. So make a decision based on what are you interested in, which institution offers it, and what within that program do they offer. Is it enticing to you? Is it something you think you would enjoy working on, or the field you would enjoy working in? And again, there's really no limit to what you can do in environmental sciences or management. For example, I'm interested in GIS. I didn't necessarily major in environmental data science, but it was still a major aspect of the project I ended up doing for my postgrad. So you can always integrate certain specializations within yours, because again, lifelong learners, if you're a scientist, you're gonna learn the rest of your life. So you can always specialize in something else and then pick up something else along the way as you grow in your career. I hope this video has helped you in some way to understand the types of specializations you can have for environmental sciences if you're thinking of doing a postgraduate degree. If you have any more questions, please drop them down below. If you want me to do an in-depth review or discussion of these specific specializations, or you're interested to know which universities in South Africa offer programs in these specializations, please comment down below and I will be sure to make that video. I hope you enjoyed today's one. I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.